The jump. I was walking toward the ledge. My hands had been shaking since the day started, but as I walked toward the cliff, my entire body started quivering. I could feel every muscle pulsating, contracting and releasing. I had no control over my body. I could barely move my legs. The sockets in my knees seemed to pop in and out of place. I felt like I had torn all the ligaments in my knee. My throat was dry. If I tried to talk, I would croak, like a man who smoked too many cigarettes. My heart was thrashing inside my chest, beating against it, trying to burst through my ribcage. The veins in my arms seemed to be filled like with helium. The weightless blood was shooting through my arms and never paused for a beat. The ledge was now perpendicular to my feet. I peered over the edge. The water at the bottom reflected the clouds above. There was a wooden plank beside me that was built 30 feet past the cliff, tempting to fall if I stepped on it. Was I really going through with this? Was this going to be the end of my life? The instructor was on the plank, setting up the bungee cords. He was a family friend, so I trusted him, but just a little. He motioned for me to walk over. I loitered over to the plank. My legs were working against gravity. A giant black hole was behind me, pulling me away from the edge. All my blood was rushing to my head. I didn't feel high, but more aloof, like I wasn't the one controlling my actions. He hooked me up to the bungee cord. He gave me the thumbs up. I jumped. They say that time goes slower or faster during exciting situations. In this case, it didn't either. I was falling as fast as I'd expected. Time was flowing normally. My brain shut off as I fell. I felt nothing, not a drop of excitement or fear. I was just falling. The bungee cord stretched more and more. I came closer to the ground, and the fear started to seep in again. My head was closest to the ground. I was sure that my head would slap against the rocks, scattering my skull and spewing my grains across the ground. I started to scream. Then I was at the pinnacle of the drop. For the slightest moment, I was completely still, but then the energy of the strange string jerked me back up. My scream turned from dread to exhilaration. I was in free fall, and now I was flying back up. How was this possible? I didn't know, but it was fun. I'd actually done it. The fun and excitement came from the fear. They were intertwined. The overwhelming fear was enjoyable, but once I realized it was fine, slight edge of fear created excitement. I believe that fun can be a product of fear.